Hi, welcome back. I'm Pumla Schmidt, and I'm just going to start off by saying thank you for being here, gentlemen, but I heard there was a problem with my spending, so we're going to talk a little bit about cost management here. I've been spending way too much in the cloud.
Absolutely.
So I'm welcome, everyone. I'm joined here by Michael Flanagan and Raphael Chaco.
Raphael Chaco.
Chaco. Well, I'm Pumla, so try to say that, you know, five times. So we're going to talk about cost management. Before we dig deep into my credit card spending problem, let's have you guys tell us a little bit about what you do here at Microsoft.
So I'm a program manager on the Azure Cost Management team, along with Michael, the program manager too, on the cost management.
Okay, cost management. So like I said, I have a credit card spending problem in the cloud. What does that really mean, from enterprises, small organizations? It's when you think cost management, you're like, okay, like is that because I spend too much, or is that analyzing data? What really is our cost management tool or service?
So cost management service is all about giving you three things. How do you get that right visibility into your data with tools to get that insights, understand where your data is coming from? And then the second part is the accountability aspect of it, is getting better control of your costs, managing your costs in a more meaningful way. And then finally, once you have that visibility and accountability, getting that right optimization. So where do you find all those savings? Where do you eliminate all of the waste on the data? So it's basically a combination of all these three things put together is what Azure Cost Management is all about.
So, technically, our little interview is called What's New with Cost Management, and that's a great brief overview of what it really is, but what's new? What have you guys announced? Because Ignite, everyone's here to bring all your shiny new tools, and you're going to flash them around and let everybody use them. So what are you guys bringing to the table for the show?
So there's a lot of things that we've brought within the past few months. One of them is forecasting. You have the ability to forecast your costs, so you can take a look at what you're currently spending and then see how that's trajected to go to make sure that that's on track with your expectations and potentially mitigate that by taking cost optimization actions. You can now look at Azure reservation purchases and even amortize that down to the individual resources, which will help you if you're needing to do any chargeback for those reservations.
Oh, so chargeback. So that is definitely like a key word. Lots of organizations.
Yes.
I mean, prior life of mine, chargebacks was a big thing. Especially with the whole virtualization boom that came in. Like how, let's dig deeper into charging back.
Yeah. Sure. So there's a lot of aspects to chargeback. Part of it is really just breaking down those costs to be able to see what each organization is charging. And tags are a great way to kind of critical to being able to break down those costs and allocate that out to each of the organizations, which is one of the things that we actually have coming, which is cost allocation.
Absolutely. So it's like, taking some shared costs. So if I'm running, for example, an express route,
okay,
and it's being shared by three applications across my organization, how do I take that shared cost and then divvy it up equally based on how much those individual applications have consumed or the individual lines of business have consumed? So it's all about giving you the tools to be able to do that in an easy way.
So the key to charging back is really using tags, though. Is that what I'm hearing?
That is one of the important aspects of that, for sure.
What else is new on the roadmap?
So some of the other things that you can do is you can, within cost management and the Azure portal, you can customize views to help you understand costs as you would in your organization. That may be via tags, the way you manage your subscriptions, or even management groups and whatnot. And you can share those views out with other people, potentially sharing links with people over email or Teams, let's say, or even getting an image of that view and sharing it in even like a status meeting.
Oh, wow, really?
Yes, and you can take those views, pin them to your dashboard, share that out with your team to make sure that everybody sees that when they sign in the portal. Because one of the biggest things within cost management that's really important is raising that visibility of the cost, because everybody needs to be aware of the costs that they're incurring and the impact that has on the bottom line, because you can't optimize costs that you don't see.
Okay, so let's say I log into the portal and I've got this cost management dashboard and I see a resource or a resource group that really is, the spending is just a little bit off budget. What can be done to bring it under control?
So the first thing is knowing what that spend is, where it is being spent. Mm-hmm. So it could be you want to know which service is spending it, you want to know which department is spending it, so where is that cost coming from? Once you understand that, then the accountability aspect that we talked about is, okay, who do you go to and say, hey, you need to get your costs under control, or doing the right optimization on those resources to figure out how to bring that cost down. And you know, it's a combination of all these things. So it's take, like somebody said, it takes a village to work all of this together. So it's how do you bring all these aspects together to bring those costs down?
So will it actually shut down underutilized virtual machines or resources?
Absolutely.
What about if you are overutilized? Can you set thresholds and say, you know what, you are just running rampant? Will automatically shut something down if you're over budget, because that's also a fear too.
Yep.
Like, you know, if I put a budget in that if you reach it, you know, it's going to shut everything down. We don't want that to happen with production.
Correct. Yeah, you can definitely set up budgets on your resource groups, subscriptions, manager groups, whatever, to get notified about those. And then if you want to go and take extra actions, you can set up an action group for those budgets to then go trigger an automation script or a runbook, whatever it may be, to take action specific to what those subscriptions need to do, because each of your subscriptions are going to run in a different way. You may have different types of resources, so you want to take action specific to that subscription, but you can definitely use a lot of the tools that are available, with whether that be logic apps or functions or whatnot, to do the things that you need to do to clean up those resources.
Well, we know that this is a multi-cloud world. I'm going to bring this up again. Yeah. What does cost management bring to this multi-cloud world?
So we have support for AWS as well. So if you are on a multi-cloud environment, what you can do very easily is use the connector that's available in Azure Cost Management. Once you set up the connector, it brings in your AWS data, and then you can view your Azure and AWS costs in that single portal experience. All the dimensionality that's available for AWS and Azure is available in a single pane of glass for you. So it makes it much, much simpler to see all your costs in a single way. It makes it easy for you to manage budgets, like Michael was talking about. If I have tags, I can actually look at my budgets across AWS and Azure in one single view. So it makes it much simpler to handle costs across both the clouds.
So it's just analyzing, it can't actually take action?
You definitely can take action. Like, for instance, we talked about using budgets. And if you have more advanced scenarios, we also have APIs that allow you to either put that data into a storage account that you can react to on a daily basis or whatnot, or even just ad hoc queries that you need to do to check costs and potentially take further action.
In AWS? In Azure, so if I was in both environments.
Yes, you can, actually what happens when you connect AWS to the cloud using Azure Cost Management, we bring all those capabilities together. You can combine both your Azure and AWS costs together into a single management group and manage that behind a single pane of glass in the Azure portal.
Okay, that actually really clarified some things for me. Well, we know there's other clouds. What's on the roadmap for other cloud scenarios?
So, we plan to GA the AWS in the early part of next quarter. And then once we're done with that, we will be working on GCP, so bringing in GCP. So if you're on like three clouds, or Azure and GCP, now you get the same functionality of cost management across all these clouds, all in a single view.
That's great. Is there, since we're all here at Ignite, any call outs to sessions your team has presented? Because I know there's a lot of questions with cost management, so I'm sure you guys have presented some sessions.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Go for it.
Because cost is such a popular topic and optimization is such a popular topic, there are quite a few sessions that have happened at Ignite. So we've had one for optimizing your cost. There was a breakout session for how to handle your costs and optimize your costs in AWS, in Azure and AWS, as well as there was a theater session today on looking at your costs, and there are a couple of other sessions on how to optimize and view your Azure costs.
So if a new enterprise is just getting into Azure, or they've been using Azure for a while, but they've never touched the cost management, what would be your recommendation for them to get started? Where can they dip their feet into just trying it out? Because most people don't want to go dive head deep first.
Yeah, I think it's best to start by just opening up cost analysis. And you can do that on even if you're only managing a single resource group, you can start on that resource group, just go to cost analysis, to just start to understand what your costs are. And then you can expand that to see what your patterns have been over time, and use there's a list of built-in views that are off that are there to give you more of a holistic view of those costs. That's really the best place to start, just because you need to understand what your costs are in order for you to identify and start to enforce any financial constraints that you may have using budgets.
And in addition to what Michael just said, I think it's also important to know that it's available for everyone in the organization.
Okay.
So whether you're looking at it from an exec point of view, whether you're looking at it from a finance point of view and just trying to reconcile your bill or set against targets, or even if you're a DevOps persona, it's available for anyone in the organization because you have the tools to do that.
So you said it's available for anyone. Let's say our bean counters.
Absolutely, yeah.
So could the bean counters actually log in and do their bean counting functions?
Yeah, absolutely. We talked a little bit about management groups and tags, using those to organize your resources. There's also billing accounts, and this is where the colloquial bean counters would be, probably.
I can say my best friend's a bean counter. So.
They're very important.
Yes, they are. They keep my spending in control. Yes,
that's right.
Somebody needs to do it.
Yes. So they can sign in and they can see their the billing accounts all up across all of the subscriptions that the organization may have. They can see all of that together in one place, right?
How does cost management tie in with like different tenancies as well?
So going back to the bean counters, they can actually see everything across the organization, regardless of how many directories those subscriptions span. When they sign into the portal, they just go to cost management and billing, and then select their billing account, and then they see, again, all those subscriptions that roll up there. They have all the same capabilities that people at a resource group have. They can use that to then first understand what they're spending, set the budgets that they need to make sure that controls are in place to notify people when they're going over budget, and then also being able to do things like export the data for any integration within their internal financial system.
I was just going to ask you that question. Yeah. You have all this data and it's sitting in the portal, but oftentimes, you know, everyone wants to take it out into Excel or another form,
Yep.
So is it just possible to export in Excel, or is there other formats so we can grab that data?
So if you're looking in, say, cost analysis, you can download your customized view either as an Excel file, a CSV, or even an image. Again, we talked about it earlier, where you could share that out with the team. You can also set up an automated export that will push that data to storage, say every day or every week or every month, depending on what you need. And then it'll just take all the data that you have, dump it there, so you can then take action on that data to, again, integrate that with any internal systems that you may have. Maybe you have, maybe you want to do some external reporting based on that to merge that data with your own business data, things like that. And there's also Power BI.
That's another one.
Yes. Right. Yeah, Power BI is also another thing. We actually just had a recent update to Power BI, and there's also some great new reporting options that we have coming for Azure Reservations, as well as Azure Hybrid Benefit. So I know that a lot of people have been asking us about that this week, so we're really excited to get those. So if anybody's here at Ignite, please stop by the Azure Cost Management booth. We'd love to talk about that.
And I think one other thing worth mentioning is APIs. So if you want programmatic access to your data, all of this functionality is available with APIs. So you can just call an API and pull the data and do what you want to do with that.
So we have the Azure Advisor. How does cost management and Azure Advisor work together?
So we partner together to really understand what are the needs that that all of our customers have collectively, to make sure that we're prioritizing the right cost recommendations. We have their experience integrated in with cost management, and we definitely believe that we need one place that customers can go to get all of their recommendations. And that's what Azure Advisor gives you. Really closely with them to make sure that we're bringing the right recommendations to our customers and give you opportunities to optimize your costs.
Yeah, and I brought that question up because oftentimes people say, doesn't Azure Advisor do the same thing? But apparently not. It's definitely deeper insight.
Yeah. So you can think that our advisor has multiple parts to it. There's recommendations for security in Advisor, there's recommendations for high availability in Advisor, and there's also a recommendation for a set of cost savings. So that's where cost management and Advisor sort of are really closely connected together in anything to do with cost savings on in Advisor.
Well, we've just got about 60 seconds left, so I want to give you two gentlemen to say whatever you want about cost management.
You want to go first, Michael?
Oh, wow, way to throw that over to me. The only thing that I would say is make sure, the big thing that people come to us and they really ask about is optimization. So the big thing that I would say is make sure that you're aware of all the optimization opportunities you have. Look at Azure reservations. There's 16 different services. It's not just VMs, so make sure that you understand that. Take a look at Azure Hybrid Benefit if you have any on-prem licenses that you aren't using because you've moved those workloads to the cloud. And the last thing I'd say is understand how the services you're using are charging you, because there's a lot of optimizations you could do there.
I was just saying, to cut you off, but we are just out of time. All right. So I want to thank you both gentlemen for being up here on Microsoft Ignite
Live stage. Thank you for having us.
And thank you everyone for watching.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.